Hello everyone, welcome to the packet tracer activity 15.2.3 from CCNP Anchor course from Cisco. This activity is about HSRP protocol. Okay, so let's read the objectives. In this packet tracer activity, we are going to configure the protocol HSRP, which is a Cisco protocol, to provide a default or backup or redundant default gateway device to the host. So as you know, the default gateway is the IP address of the interface of the router, close the one closest to the LAN. So here for PC4LAN 1, we have the default gateway, the IP address of this router here. And for LAN 2, we have the default gateway, the IP address of this router here. So this, what is the problem here? If one router will fall down or will break, so the path will not be existed to the server. So to avoid this problem, there is a protocol. The name of it is Host Standby Router Protocol. It's a Cisco protocol, one more time, to use like a default, like a redundant one. When this one will be like not working, so that another path will be used, which is this one. Okay, what we need to this, of course, we need to change the default to provide a new IP address, and then we need to change the default gateway in the PCs, the default gateway in the switches. Okay, so let's keep going here. What we are going to use, we to do to configure HSRP active router, one of them. And then we are going to configure a standby router to cover when the active router is not working. And then we are going to verify the connectivity or the operation. Okay, so one of them is going to be the active router, which is always working. And we will do this. I will show you how to make one router an active router by using a simple command with a specific value, which is more than 100. And then we are going to set this as a standby router. When the active router is not working, the standby router is going to work. Okay, so what about the scenario? Here we know that spanning tree protocol, which is STP, provides a loop-free redundancy between switches within a LAN. However, it does not provide redundant default gateways for each user devices within the network if gateway router fails. Okay, first, hop redundancy protocol, which is FHRP, provide redundant default gateway. Here we are going to configure HSRP because this is a Cisco protocol. Okay, so you will configure HSRP on router 1 and router 3, which serve, I mean the two routers, as the default gateways for the host on LAN 1 and LAN 2. You will configure HSRP. You will create a virtual gateway that uses the same default gateway address for the host in both LANs. If one gateway router becomes unavailable in the situation, the second router will take over using the same default gateway address that was used by the first router. Because of the host on the LAN are configured with the IP addresses and the virtual gateway as the default gateway, the host will regain connectivity to remote network after HSRP activates the remaining router. Okay, let's now first verify connectivity. We are going now first to trace the path to the web server from PCA. Let's take this command here. And we are going to PCA, and then let's go and check here, trace the router. Okay, as you see, the trace complete. First, we have 192.168.1.1, which is this one, which is gigabit Ethernet 01 on router 1. This is here. And then we have 10.1.1.2, which is this one, which is the IP address of router 2, which is this one here. And then we have 10.100.102, which is this one, which is INET, which is this one, or Internet. And finally, we have 209.168.200.226, which is the IP address of the server. Okay, so what we need this IP address as a virtual address. Okay, here what as you can see, we have a question, which device are on the path from PCA to the web server. You can see the answer is here, which is R1, R2, INET, and web server. Okay, on step 2, we have to trace the path to the web server from PC. BCB. Okay, let's do this. So we have this one, and then this one, and then INET, and then the server. So R3, R2, and so on. Okay. Here we also have what devices are on the path from PCB to the web server. So we have here, we already saw the screen. In step 3, we have observed the network behavior when R3 becomes unavailable. So here we are going to remove R3. And then, we need to remove the link between R3 and S3. So this link is going to be removed. And then let's repeat the process. So as you can see here, request timeout because there is no way the link is broken. Okay, so control C here to break or interrupt operation. Okay, so compare the current output with the output of the command from step 2. Of course, now we don't have path to the server. And here we are going to fix the connection. So here, click the connections icon. On the lower left corner of the packet tracer window, locate the copper straight through. And then we put here on gigabit Ethernet 02. And on R1, gigabit Ethernet 00. Okay, so here after the link lights on the connection are both green, test the connectivity again by ping. Okay, so let's do this now. Now it's going to make trace out or ping all the same. As you can see here, we have now a connectivity. Okay, so in part 2, we are going now to configure HSRP active and standby routers. Okay, let's go here on the router, enable, and then configure terminal. Let's see what we need to do. First, to activate the protocol, we need to activate it inside the interface itself. This is the first point. So when you need to activate this HSRP protocol, you need to activate it on each interface that you would like. So since here we have the interface, as you can see here, gigabit Ethernet 01. As you can see here, this one, gigabit Ethernet 01. So let's do this one, so interface gigabit 01. And then we need to activate protocol by type standby and then version 2. And then we give the IP address of the virtual router. And as you can see here, the IP address is this one here. Okay, so what we have next, we have now a very important point that we need to remember. As you know, so this router, we would like this router to be an active router. As you can see here, since there is no other routers in this using the version standby, so by default it started to be an active. Why? Because as you can see here, we have the priority is 100. So the default priority is 100. But when this router will fail down or will not work, this router is going to be inactive. Of course, the default value for this, the priority is 100, and this one will be the active. When this router will appear or will work again, it will not, it won't be the active again because the active is here until this active it will fall down, and then will this one will take over to be an active. But in this activity, we need this router to be an active router at the beginning, and when fell down, and then when fails down, or then there is another router in the situation. So to do this, we have to increase the default value of the priority from 100 to put it 150, as you can see here. Okay, this is the first step. Next is the second step, that when this router will fell down and then will work again, will be available again, we need it always to be the active. Since this router is active, since this router is working, so this router is going to be the active. So to do this, we need to specify that this is a router with the command preemit, as you can see here. Now we have the priority of this router 150, and then we have the preemit. That means that when the router will work again, or when it will come to life again, it's going to be the active router. Okay, so to achieve this process, we need priority 150, and then we have preemit to be like standby one preemit. Okay, as you can see here, we have a question: what will the HSRP priority on R3 be when it added HSRP group 1? Of course, it's going to be 100 because this is the default value. Okay, so let's keep going, and now let's do the same process on R3. First, we need to know the interface, which is Gigabit Ethernet 00. Enable here configure terminal and interface Gigabit 00. And then we are going, of course, to specify that this router is going to be standby router, version 2. And then we are going to put the IP address of the virtual gateway. Okay, so that's it. We have done with this. We don't need to specify the priority. It's going by default 100. Okay, and now we are going to repeat the process on step 1 and step 3, which will check the way from PCA to the server. Now it was this way. Now we are going to check also here. Okay, here we have a problem that we forget to change the IP address on the devices. So the default gateway here is going to be this one, and this also here is going to be this one, and of course we need to change here default gateway. And here is also, this is a very important point. Okay, so now let's check again. As you can see here, we have this path 192.168.1.1. And as you can see here, 192.168.1.1, which is this way. It was starting to be this one, not this one anymore. Okay, now Let me try to delete this link again. As you remember, in the first step, in the beginning, we have no connection to the server. Now let's see. As you can see here, now we have reached to this one. As you can see here, tries completed, and then we have one more time. As you can see here, one more time. Now we still have, now we have access to the server, even that when this link is broken. Okay, so let's see what we have else. So we have also questions. I'm going to answer the questions, and you will find the file with the packet tracer, as you know, in the description box. Thank you very much, and I will see you in the next video.